the praise, God. For that I give you the honor, God. You have brought me to another Friday. Glory be to God, a Friday that I've never seen before. And when it is over, I'll never see it again. And so for that, God, I give you praise. For that, God, I give you honor. For that, God, I give you worthy. God, you are so worthy to be praised. Glory be to God. Hey, Pamela, good morning. Good morning. God bless you. God, you are worthy. Hallelujah. You are worthy to be praised today. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, your name is worthy. God, I thank you. God, I thank you for this Friday. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. God, I just want to give you the praise, Father. I want to give you the honor, the glory, God. Hallelujah, for what you're doing, God, in my life, for what you're doing in your people's life today, God. I thank you for giving us another opportunity. Glory be to God. We have lived long enough to know that we don't take these days for granted. Glory be to God, because, Father, we know, glory be to God, that somebody somewhere made plans to wake up today. Glory be to God, but they didn't wake up. And so, God, we don't take this for granted today that you've given us another chance. Hallelujah, to call upon your name. Glory be to God. God, we worship you today. Not because we need anything, but God, we worship you because of who you are. You are the true and the living God, and there is no God beside you. And so we humbly bow down before you, God. We surrender to you today, God. All of you today, Father, and none of us today, God. All of you today, Father God, and none of us today, God. We just come to say we thank you. We come to say we honor you. We come to say that we appreciate you, God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. We just thank you, God. Hallelujah. For all of your mercy that you have bestowed upon us today. In the name of Jesus, glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Well, I had to get that praise out. Hallelujah. I had to get that worship out. Hallelujah. As you come on, please share the live broadcast. I do appreciate it. Hallelujah. I am so honored to have you in my presence today. For the Bible say, where any two or three are gathered in his name, there he is in the midst. Glory be to God. Could it be that where it's even in cyberspace? Glory be to God. So I thank God, hallelujah, that he is in the midst of his people today. And I just stopped by today on this Friday, glory be to God, or whatever day or time it is you may be viewing this broadcast, just to share this, this prophetic word that the Lord gave to me on yesterday. It was so rich. It just really blessed my life. So I just really want to share it with you. Amen. It's not a long word, but I tell you this, it's a powerful word. Amen. Hallelujah. Not a long word, but a powerful word. Sometimes we just need that one little word. Amen. Hallelujah. To help us on our journey. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. And so the word of the Lord came to me on yesterday. Hallelujah. As I was praying, as I was ending my prayer, hallelujah, I heard the Lord say to me, just as loud and clear, glory be to God, this word came to me. He said, be bold, be fierce. I, the Lord, am with thee. Be bold, be fierce. I, the Lord, am with thee. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Honey, right there, I can shut the mic. I can slam the door or whatever else at that point in time when I heard the Lord gave me that word. Glory be to God. Everything else was over. Glory be to God. Let me tell you, saints, there is nothing like when you know that the Lord is behind you. Nothing else matter. Nobody else matter. Even if a giant was after you, if 10,000 came after you, glory be to God. But after such a profound and a prolific word from the Lord, glory be to God, it will strengthen you just like in the days of When I was a kid, I don't know about you guys or your age group. Well, I'm looking at the names, so yeah, you guys are pretty much in that same age group where cartoons come on and it was Popeye. Popeye was an ordinary man, but when he needed strength, he ate that spinach. And the spinach, and he would show his muscles that the spinach made him strong. Amen. Hallelujah. So this word of the Lord came to me yesterday. Hallelujah. And it was as if Popeye's spinach was put down in my body. Amen. Hallelujah. He said, behold. He said, be bold, be fierce. I, the Lord, am with thee. Amen. So if you were scared about anything, if you were trembling about anything, if you are concerned about anything, glory be to God. When you hear that word, it shut everything down. Amen. Hallelujah. So I just want to define these two words. And I know that you guys are uber smart. You're very, very smart. Hallelujah. So I'm not defining it because you don't know what these words mean, but just to add a little bit of flavor to it. Is it all right? Is that okay? Amen. Hallelujah. He told me, he said, be bold. Glory be to God. So bold is a person, or it's when a person or take some kind of action or an idea. Amen. Hallelujah. That displays confidence. Glory be to God. Confidence. Glory be to God. And that person is willing to take a risk, or that person is very courageous or have courage. Glory be to God. That you may need courage in something. And so that boldness will rise up in you. That's when a person is take an action or have an idea that give them that confidence. Amen. Hallelujah. Whereas you would not take a risk. The world may deem it as a risk, but God may say it is faith. Come on, somebody. Let me put it like that. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Glory be to God. Where you stepping out on faith. The world may say it is a risk. Glory be to God. But you have your faith in God. Hallelujah. For the Bible say that it is impossible to please God without faith. Amen. So you got to rise up. Not you, only you, but me. Amen. Hallelujah. To have that boldness, that courage, that confidence. Glory be to God. To know that all heaven is backing you. To know that God is backing you. So that's that one word. Amen. Hallelujah. Bold, bold. I want you to set that in your spirit. Set that word in your heart. And sometimes boldness have a negative connotation, because we hear people say, oh, she bold, he bold, or that was bold. We're not talking about that negative side of boldness. We're talking about that boldness where, you know, you rise up in the confidence of the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Where you know that you're going to step out on faith. Glory be to God. Because you know that. You know that you know. Down in your sanctified knowing, you know that God has told you. Glory be to God. Amen. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. This word just really blessed me yesterday. Glory be to God. When the Lord spoke to me and say, be bold, be fierce. I, the Lord, thy God, is with thee. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. So I want to define the next word, fierce. Fierce. It's displaying an intense or ferocious aggressiveness. Amen. Hallelujah. And so when I begin to listen to that definition, amen, as I read it from the dictionary, come on, hallelujah, I begin to think on this. Listen again. Amen. I'm getting excited. I get excited with the word of God. Fierceness. When you displaying an intense or ferocious aggressiveness. When I begin to think about that, I think about what came to me is mainly you use this type of action or attitude against a predator. Amen. You're not just being fierce just because you want to act some kind of way out of the will of God. But that's when you rise up to say, you know what, Satan? You're not going to have me. Come on. Hallelujah. So you begin to be ferocious against your predator. You begin to get aggressive against your predator. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Let me say that word again. Hallelujah. Be bold. Be fierce. I, the Lord, thy God, is with thee. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. God wants you to be fierce. Glory be to God. Be fierce in him. Hallelujah. Rise up knowing that God has you. Glory be to God. Knowing that God backs you. Hallelujah. And two scriptures, glory be to God, that I want to tie in to the word of the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. When he gave me this word, this is what you call the Rhema word. Amen. When God just speak that word, it's not written nowhere. It's just something that God has spoke. So when God spoke that Rhema word to me on yesterday, glory be to God, immediately two words came to me, not the Rhema. Hallelujah. I mean, the logos. I add the logos, that's the written word. I add the logos to the Rhema word, amen, that God gave me on yesterday. Glory be to God. And so that's taken from Matthew. One of the passages come from Matthew chapter 10 and verse 16. He said, behold, Jesus said, behold, I send you forward as sheep in the midst of wolves. Come on. Hallelujah. Be ye therefore wise as serpents and harmless as doves. Come on. See that serpent. If we go back to, the book of Genesis in the Garden of Eden, that serpent was so wise and so cunning till he was able to, take Adam and Eve out of their birthright. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. But Jesus said, guess what? I send you forth as sheep. Glory be to God. That's calm. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. In the midst of wolves. Come on. Hallelujah. You already know, as children of the Most High God, amen, as sheep in the Lord's pasture. Come on. Hallelujah. You know the wolves want to ravage you and devour you. Come on. Hallelujah. How many times you've been lied on? How many times you've been played? How many times you've been cheated on? How many times you have been mistreated? Come on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We can't run, hallelujah, because we're in this world. We may not be of this world, but we're in this world. So we're going to come in contact with all kind of people, and we're going to come in contact with all kind of situations. Jesus already said that. He said, I'm sending you forward as sheep in the midst of wolves. Be ye therefore wise. Come on. Glory be to God. Wise as serpents and harmless as doves. Come on. Hallelujah. Be wise. That's one of the words that the Lord gave me for this year. Glory be to God, that we need to move in wisdom. Wise is a derivative of wisdom. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. We got to have wisdom. Hallelujah. In this season. Glory be to God. And yet we're going to be bold and fierce because we know that the Lord is with us. And so the next scripture that the Lord gave me is Matthew 11 and 12. And I know all of this is so familiar to you, but yes, the Bible says faith come by hearing and hearing by the word of God. So the more you hear the word of God, the more your faith is going to be built up. Amen. Hallelujah. Matthew chapter 11 and verse 12. And from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and violent take it back by force. Come on, somebody. Thank you, Pamela, for posting those scriptures. Glory be to God. The kingdom of heaven. Glory be to God. See, hallelujah. We belong to the kingdom of heaven, but the kingdom of heaven is always suffering violently. Come on. That's nothing new under the sun. He said, And from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffered violently, and the violent take it by force. Come on. Glory be to God. So we, as the people of God, as the children of God, as the sons and the daughters of God, glory be to God, we got to be rise up to begin to take back the kingdom of heaven. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. And take it back by force. That's why the Lord say, be bold, be fierce. Come on. Glory be to God. Let that confidence rise up in you. Come on. You got to be intense. Hallelujah. You got to act ferocious and aggressive. Come on. Glory be to God. You got to know that God sent you. And when the Lord sent you, you can't let the devil and his host of hell take nothing that God has given you. Sometimes we lay back and we become too passive. Glory be to God. When we need to be aggressive. Come on. Sometimes we get the roles mixed up. Amen. Hallelujah. We're aggressive when we need to be passive. And sometimes we're passive when we need to be aggressive. But can I tell you, in this season, glory be to God, you got to be ferocious. Come on. Hallelujah. Against that enemy. I believe it's 1 Peter 5 and 8. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. If I'm wrong, check me on that. Or it could be 7. Hallelujah. It says, Satan goes about like a roaring lion, seeking whomever he may devour. But he say, you got to be sober. You got to be vigilant. Come on. Hallelujah. 1 Peter 5 and 8. Come on. I see it. He say, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walking about, seeking whom he may devour. Come on. Hallelujah. The enemy come to want to devour you. Glory be to God, to take the things that God has given you. Glory be to God, but God has given you permission. Hallelujah. To take it back, and to take it back by force. Come on. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. You got to stamp on the enemy and let him know, glory be to God, you gets nothing here. What God has for me is for me. I'm not just saying it out of my mouth. I'm going to demonstrate it with my actions. Come on. Hallelujah. I'm going to demonstrate it with my actions. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. In 2021, God, the Lord gave me a word for 2021. Say, tell the people, glory be to God, I want them to stand on this word. Hallelujah. To shut it down. And I'm keeping that word in this year. Come on. Hallelujah. You got to shut down the plans, the plots, the tricks, the tactics of the enemy. Come on. Glory be to God. So we go to what it is. Isaiah 47 and 17. Somebody may be saying, Apostle Proctor, you're quoting a lot of scripture. Yes, because guess what? It is my ammunition. It is our sword of the spirit. This is the way we fight. Come on. We don't fight through flesh and blood. We use the word of God. Glory be to God. The word of God says in Isaiah 54 and 17, glory be to God. He said, no weapon formed against you shall prosper, and every tongue that rise up against you, you condemn it. Come on. Glory be to God. God wants you to begin to rise up and be bold and begin to condemn. Glory be to God. The tactics of the wild, the tactics of the enemy. You got to begin to shut it down. You got to begin to open up your mouth. As the kingdom of heaven suffered violently, you got to take back what the enemy has stole from you. You got to take it back by force. Come on. Glory be to God, because God has empowered you. He has equipped you. Glory be to God. God has given you permission to be bold, to be fierce. Glory be to God, and he's echoing this to you. Glory be to God, that the God, hallelujah, of heaven's army is with you. Glory be to God, the same God that parted the Red Sea for Moses and the children of Israel is the same God, glory be to God, that will back you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm not telling you something I don't know. I'm not just telling you this because, hey, I know the word of God. Glory be to God. This thing has to come, hallelujah, into play in my life. Come on. Glory be to God. Again, as I was praying on yesterday morning, glory be to God, because I got tired of a situation and I began to put it before the Lord. Glory be to God. Sometimes people want you to sit back and just act passive. Why? Because, oh, you saved. Oh, you supposed to be a preacher. Oh, you're not supposed to act like that. But guess what? God give you power and he give you authority. He give you power and authority to stamp on the devil's neck. Come on. Luke chapter 10 and 19 says what? Behold, I've given you power to trample on the scorpion and the serpent, and nothing shall by any means harm you. But if you don't shut it down and if you don't step on his neck, then you give that thing permission to wreak havoc in your life. Come on. Glory be to God. So after I prayed, I heard the Lord spoke back to me. Glory be to God again. Glory be to God. I'm going to say it again. Glory be to God. Because I believe that this word will not only work in my life, I believe that it's going to work in your life as well. Amen. Be bold, be fierce. For I, the Lord, thy God, is with thee. Come on. Glory be to God. So guess what? I had to go and deal with a situation. I had to let that person know, look a here. It ain't going to work like that. It ain't going to go down like that. You're not going to handle me like this. You're not going to talk to me like this. You're not going to do it. Come on. You're not going to do it. And guess what? I didn't have to twist my neck. I didn't have to act like what they call us, the angry black women, because guess what? I'm just as intelligent as you. Glory be to God. But I come to you, glory be to God, in the name of the Lord. Come on, like David said, glory be to God. You come against me, Goliath. Come on. But I come to you in the name of the Lord. David said, come on, with these same hands, I have killed the lion and I have killed the bear. Come on. And I know that God has anointed my mouth like a two-edged sword. Come on. I can give it to you in a professional way, but all heaven army is going to back me up. Come on. Glory be to God. And so when I said what I had to say, glory be to God, can I tell you that person had to bow down to the God in me? Well, I didn't mean it. I say, well, your words and your action. And I'm telling you, you're not going to speak to me like that. You're not going to talk to me like that. You're not going to deal with me like that. Glory be to God. And guess what? I started to walk away. I started to walk away from this blessing that God gave me. But I had to rise up and say, no, God, you gave me this. And the host of hell ain't going to take it from me. When I walk away, it's when I say, you know what? I'm through. I'm through. That's when I'm going to walk away. I'm not going to walk away because the enemy think he could control me. It ain't going to work. It ain't going to work here. Not when I know that all heaven backs me up. Not when I know that all heaven backs me up. Come on. Glory be to God. God say, baby, I give you power. I give you authority. Glory be to God. Do you not know who you are? Do you not know that you are the king's kid? Glory be to God. Do you not know they're supposed to bow to you because God is in you? Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. I don't believe that God spoke that to me just for me. I believe he spoke that to me for my situation. Glory be to God, but to share it as well, because you may be going through a situation. Glory be to God. You may be going through something and don't know how to articulate what you need to articulate. Don't know the right move to make. Come on, somebody. Because sometimes we feel like we're going to lose if we defend ourselves. Well, if I defend myself, this little contract may be taken from me. No, I'm going to defend myself. What God gave to me is me. It's for me. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. So what am I telling you today? Glory be to God. Be bold. Be fierce. Know that God is with you. If God has brought you to that situation, he's going to be with you in it. Glory be to God. Sometimes we don't know how God is going to move. But here's the thing. We know he's going to move. We'll know how he's going to intervene. But we know he's going to intervene. If he did it for Daniel in the lion's den, if he did it for Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, he'll do it for you. He's the same God yesterday, today, and forever. Glory be to God. But he wants us to rise up. Glory be to God. We don't want to just read these stories. He's the same God. Amen. Glory be to God. So, beloved, I believe that I shared with you what the Lord laid on my heart for you, for his people. If you have not subscribed to this page, go ahead and subscribe to the page. Turn on the notification bell. That way, when I come on, you are privileged to the content that God is giving me for you. I know sometimes they are sporadic, depends on my schedule. There are some times when my schedule is free, and then there are some times when my schedule is not free. So it will be best to subscribe to the channel, turn on a notification bell. That way you will get the notification. And I'm going to ask you to pray for me, to pray for this ministry as I pray for you. And so let us go out in prayer. And if you have a prayer request, you can go ahead and drop it in the comments. If you don't want to drop it in the comments, you can go ahead and inbox me. I will gladly come into the power of agreement with you in prayer. Amen. So let us end in prayer. Father, we just thank you and we praise you. We humbly come before you, God. We thank you for this privilege that you have allowed us to come before your throne of grace any time of day or night with any situation. Lord, we thank you because we know that you care for us, Father. God, we just thank you. And we don't take this for granted, that we are able to approach the throne of grace. God, we thank you because you said in your word in Psalms 138 and verse 8 that you will perfect everything that concerns us. And God, you know the things that we have on our heart and our mind. You know the struggles that we face every day, God. You know the struggles we face even in our family, even the challenges in our body, Lord God. Some of dealing with mental challenges, physical challenges, emotional challenges, financial challenges. Some are going through on their jobs, even in their marriage, God. Some are going through even with their children and grandchildren. God, some are having even problems with their siblings, God. Some of this stuff been going on forever, God, with sibling robbery. And so, Father, we thank you today that we are able to shut down the plans of the enemy in the mighty name of Jesus. And God, we just thank you today that no weapon formed against us shall prosper, no matter what type of weapon it is. God, we just say, like you told us, you gave us the authority that we condemn everything that rise up against us. We condemn sickness, any manner of sickness, even this virus that's been running rampant in our country. We shut it down. We condemn it. God, even those that are struggling on their jobs, again, in their marriages, in their businesses. God, whatever lie the enemy has spoken on us, we condemn it now. It will not work. It cannot work. God, you say whatever, whenever we pray, we have this confidence. And Lord, that takes us back to that word to be bold. We have this confidence in you, God, that whatever we pray, oh God, in your name, God, according to your will, Father, we know that we have it and it will come to pass. And so, God, we mortals here on earth, we tend to get excited about Friday because it's the close of a work week. And so, God, we just say, yay, 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 God. We thank you for bringing us to this fabulous Friday, to this fierce Friday. God, we thank you for being our Jehovah Jireh, our provider. God, for blessing us and blessing us. Oh God, for opening up the windows of heaven, pouring us our blessings that we don't have room enough to receive. God, God, we thank you that all things are working for our good. Father, that's your word, God. We're just only praying back your word. God, you say all things work for the good of those who love the Lord, who are called according to your purpose. And God, we thank you because we know we're called according to your purpose. And all of these little aggravating things is going to work for our purpose. And we thank you in advance. We praise you in advance. In the mighty name of Jesus, we say amen and amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. God, I'm giving you praise in advance, God. I thank you. Glory be to God for giving me faith to move mountains, God. I thank you. Glory be to God. Lord, I praise you. Glory be to God. I just celebrate the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. For the Lord is good. Amen. Hallelujah. So just be encouraged. Be encouraged. Amen. Know that no weapon formed against you shall prosper. Every tongue that rises up against you, that has risen up against you, just move forward and remember the word of the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. To be bold, to be fierce, and knowing that the Lord thy God is with thee. Amen. Hallelujah. And I'm just reminded of this, and then I'm going to go for real. Jesus even told his disciples, he said, take nothing with you. Take no bag. He said what? Take no script. Don't take nothing with you. He said, even when you go before the magistrate, come on, hallelujah, the judge, those that is in high places. He said, don't even worry about what you're going to say when you go before them. He said, when you open up, ooh, ha, yada, bo, shata. He said, when you open up your mouth, I'll speak for you. Sometimes we don't know what to say. God, I don't even know what to say. But God, Jesus told his disciples, he said, don't worry about it. He said, even before you go, when you go before the magistrates, he said, don't worry about what you're going to say. He said, when you open up your mouth, he said, I will speak for you. Somebody needed to hear that. Because the Holy Ghost wouldn't have brought it to me. Glory be to God. So don't even worry about it. Don't even try to rehearse that thing in your head. Don't even try to rehearse it in your head. God said, when you go before those higher ups, God say, when you open up your mouth, it's just going to rip. He'll give you the words to speak. And his words, they are spirit and they are life. You see, the flesh profited nothing, but the spirit give life. He say, my words, come on. He say, it give life. Well, God bless you, Pamela. God bless you. Thank you for being with me on this Fierce Friday. God bless you, Stephanie. Thank you for being with me on this Fierce Friday. I hope you guys have a fantastic day. You see what I need to go do. God bless you guys. And I love you with the love of God. Bye for now.